They already have some challenges. Yeah. And the work they are doing too is not very good for them. So that's why most of the time they come here and stand here. They work from their homes from here. And they come here to get free rides to their workplaces.
What we are doing here today is that we are targeting a few workers and then we are trying to introduce the unions to them. People are not guaranteed sustenance of job. Chances are that they are not even being paid their social security. They have meager salary. And so they are always here to struggle for a free ride. The papers have messages of assurance that the union can come together to support you. And so we are trying to create the awareness here.
We thought we'd have stickers. We didn't. We dealt with it. We got phone numbers, we talked to people about their rights, it was okay.
I can say that if you want to find cheap labor, that's where you can find them. Because most of these people are slum settlers. And even if a union here has ventured, TUC Ghana, our duty is to support these unions to organize well, effectively. So it means if we are able to organize them, it's not the money or the dues we'll get from them, but the fulfillment that we have helped them better their lives at the workplace alone, I think should be enough for us.
La realidad es muy fuerte aquí en este país, es muy dura, pobre gente que no tiene otra salida que naturalizarse con lo poco que tiene, necesita un poco más de dignidad y creo que los trabajadores tenemos que empezar a trabajar y a transformar la realidad de todos los trabajadores. No puede ser que aquí en Ghana los trabajadores estén totalmente precarizados.
I think that sharing experience, despite the fact that the countries are really different and context is really different, is very useful personally for me and I think for the group.
The collaboration and the meeting of that kind of international groups, learning from each other, but also sharing your own experience and adapting the things that you learn at your own realities. Because anyway, we are facing some differences, but we can learn from each other.
They were very fruitful discussions to learn about what's been the great work that everyone's been doing around the world over the last year, and also think about planning and what leadership role this committee can play for youth in the trade union movement moving forward.
Lo que hablé con mis compañeros de Ghana y mis compañeros a nivel internacional, lo puedo implementar en mi organización. Mucho acerca sobre el tema de cómo organizar o cómo reclutar personas para el sindicato. Hicimos una tarea en piso. Creo que voy a hablar con mis dirigentes en las organizaciones para hacer esta misma actividad o algo similar para llevarlo hacia Colombia, hacia las organizaciones.
Young people are facing many issues. However, when they face issues and they want to solve issues, trade unions are not there. So for them, like the trade unions are not for them. But it doesn't mean that they don't need trade unions, but they need trade unions, but the trade unions are not really close to young people. So this means like we really need to help like the activities and actions dedicated to young people. And to do so, we need to have more youth in like decision making. We need to have the youth structures. Even then, trade union needs to invest in youth more.
There's been a lot of activities in the course of the week, but it's been very fruitful because then the trade union movement is all about membership, and membership is building, it's more of organizing. And one of the thematic areas as trade unions we are looking on is the issue of organizing. And so for them to be here, experience how we organize here in Ghana, interact with organizers in Ghana, we share experiences with them, they also share their experiences with us. It's been a very fruitful week. And I'm grateful that I was able to host them in my country.